So he's not going to be excited about this part.
It's going to be uncomfortable, unfortunately. But once they get matted like that, it needs to come out. So to help me do that, I'm going to have to use the hemostats. I'm going to use some ear powder just so I can get a grip. Hemostat because they're kind of gooey. Make sure I'm in focus. Alright, here comes the hard part.
Yeah.
When they get these big old mats inside of the ears, it's blocking up the hearing, it's blocking up the breathing of the ear. You can create all kind of problems. But what I like to do first is kind of like pull it a little bit like this, just to try to get it as far out of the canal as possible. And see, it's already come out quite a bit. Now you clamp onto the mat itself, and here comes the part that's not so favorite. Oh goodness, it come off because it got hooked. It got hooked onto the thing.
Start. You're mad. You're upset. It's pretty good. Now, I'm not a really big ear plucker anymore. I've seen that plucking ears causes more problems than not. I used to be the other direction on it. I used to give everyone a hard time if they didn't pluck the dog's ears, but to be honest with you, all this extra fuss inside of the canal is not good for it. It's better to cut the hair at the corner of the ear canal. But the problem is if you're not taking good care of that hair that's inside of the canal, you're going to end up with these mats inside of the ears. And all you have to do to take care of the hair inside of the ear canal is just cleaning the ear, because that's going to straighten out the hair and untwist it. You go inside and doing that. But this is pretty thick and hard. You figure that's my thumbnail. Now my fingers are disgusting.
Now he's stressed out. He's stressful, and I'm sorry, but...